So, let's talk about SGC 68. Well, this is the big edition of it, but it's basically a 3D printable paintball marker with internals of a TPX from Tipman. It got quite some options out there. This is the top rail edition. The normal top rail is quite high. I've also made an edition that makes the rail a little bit lower. I think it looks a little better than the high one. There's also an edition that's called Nora. Then the body doesn't have a rail. This can all be found in the manual that you can download with the file. So it should be clear when you read that kind of stuff. Also with the shrouds, it's the same thing. You have shrouds with no rail on it, of the rail or a low rail. So you can go and mix it up all you want. Well, this does use the TPX internals. I've removed the capability of using the C2 gram capsules. So this is like remote line use only. So basically, if you want, you can use remote line with CO2, but basically this makes it an compression air only marker. Personally, I use a TC air valve inside instead of the TPX valve because it gives better performance. But you can use TPX parts or TC air parts. If you really want to know specifically what parts you need, again, read the manual. The part list, the manual of this project. They can really read the numbers, the product numbers, and go ahead and buy them, or just know what type you need to use. I also will make a video to how to assemble one and some other things, but this is just a short video, knowing me about just the marker itself. You can also use a lot of different buttstock options. This is the lower buffer tube edition. For paintball, this is better because your face is getting bigger because of the mask you wear, so you can shoulder it a little bit better. GC9 edition would be a higher sitting buffer tube, and there would be a small one, so it can use normal AR stocks, but you will see there are also thicker ones. It's just a matter of taste if you want to go for that one or you want to use a smaller one, the more traditional buffer tube style. So you can use a normal buttstock on it for an AR. For the higher buffer tube edition, there's a compromise that needed to be made because the remote line needs to go kind of exactly where the buffer tube will be sitting, so there will be a shape cut out of the buffer tube, so the remote line can sit in that place. So there will be three models: one normal remote line without a slide check, and a slide check is this part of the remote line, for those who don't know, that will be an on and off. Again, this is explained in the manual, but that makes it so it can sit together with the buffer tube. But also the push connect edition. Push connect is one that I use, so it's a little bit different shape. You could use the slide check model and just use it for every type of remote line, but it's a bigger one, so it's more, yeah, I think it's cleaner when you choose the right size for it, and it's at least less compromising. So this is the higher buffer tube, and what you can see right here is that is the cut made for the remote line. So you can place in this case the push connect in there, but what you will see is that it kind of interferes with the buttstock as well, so it needs to be kind of all out, or you need to sacrifice your buttstock and kind of make a cut in here as well. So yeah, I leave that up to you. If you really want to have the high buffer tube in the first place, And if you want to modify your buttstock for that, or just use it in the highest position, that's not too bad, but you get what I'm saying. And this is how it shoulders. I mean, with no mask on, it's okay, but with a panel mask on, it gets a bit higher. So you may not want to do the higher buffer tube edition. And this is just an end cap edition, so there's no buffer tube on it or something like that. Yeah, it's all a matter of taste, and of course it depends on maybe the shroud you use on the front side, if it looks right or not in proportion. But yeah, it's a possibility. Then there's also the option to use Tippmann A5 or Tippmann X7 buttstocks. Those work with two push pins, and that's what locks them in place. So it's just a matter of taking a buttstock you like, print the correct adapter for it. It will sit around this height, and then just use two push pins to lock it in place. Yeah, I cannot really show it, I've not printed that one, but that's kind of how it works. It's just a matter of placing it inside and then use two push pins. And then in this case you got a collapsible buttstock. I don't... maybe? Yeah, it would fold. It's not a problem. It's not that the body is too thick or anything. So in this case, yeah, it would work. To be honest, it would sit a little bit more forward than this, but more like this. So yeah, it's not too bad. Yeah, the safety is like an AR safety. The thing is, the trigger will move. There's a modification I needed to make it work. But yeah, when you put it on fire, it will go just a little bit further. In that case, it can actually activate the fire mechanism inside once you have air on it. The charging handle is a fake one. It will only go halfway, or not even halfway. So you can attach that if you want or not. If you don't like the idea of that, then you can just leave it off. This is a long barrel shroud. That's how it's called. And this is with a 13 inch shroud. So that's kind of give you an idea how much it will stick out. Also, by the way, it can use any type of AR grip. If you, what you like. You can just like a normal AR. You can just untighten the bolts and remove it. And this Macwell system, you would say it would be the same, exact same model as I normally use with the... let's say the AK pedal style design. I kind of redesigned it, so it will use the FGC9 type of Mac release. So you got a button on this side, and you got one at your trigger finger. You can just move it up and use it. Or use it on the other side. And so as you can see, like with Tippmann magazines, it will jump out and fall out. If you would like to adjust the velocity on this marker, then so you can adjust it to the right FPS, you do need to remove the end cap or the buffer tube, depends on what you're using. Also, this is kind of the max length shroud that I at least have made. I have some different designs, but it's kind of the max in size. Yeah, if you remove the cap, then you can, this is not the right key, but then in principle you can just insert the key and adjust it. Take a few shots, so it will adjust the air pressure inside, so it equalizes in the right setting. Then check again and make some adjustments again, and you can and then take a few shots, measure again on the meter. You know the drill if you have a TPX. So this marker will use with the 7 round TPX magazines. that will look like this on this big shroud. The 12 round TPX magazines. And the Zeta Max. This is called 20 rounds. It's like 10, and then you need to flip it around and you can shoot another 10. Also keep in mind you need to activate it at the bottom every time you insert it for the spring to activate. But that's how this would look. So as you can see, it will more work with the Mac couplers. So this is a 12 rounder with the magazine coupler and 4 7 round magazines. There's also a Mac coupler that just couples two of them together in case you have a few of them and you say like this. In this case it kind of makes still sense to use them. You could do that. It's kind of made for fun, but it works. What you also could do is attach the 3D printed AK front sight and gas block. In this case, because I needed to fix this print that did not print all the way, you cannot insert the gas block inside, but normally you can with this shroud. You can insert it a little bit so it looks a little bit better than this. You can see that it stops too soon. But yeah, in case you like that, yeah, you can do that. It's barrels like from MCS and I think also Lepco. You got like threaded barrels, so you can attach some fake muzzle brakes on it. It doesn't really serve a function at all. Unless you use the Navoske, I would call it a sound amplifier. It's like a big cup on the front and that will direct all the sound forward, and people will notice that you are on the field. If that is if you want some attention, that can be a good thing. No, but in all seriously, I do like that attachment. It it's kind of intimidating for a lot of people. There are people who are really, if you are like an ambush type of player, it's really amazing because people are, it's kind of, you could also say like it's better to be a silent ambush player, but it's also really intimidating when you are that player that goes assumedly attack somebody from the side and it's really loud and noisy and they don't think straight anymore. Sometimes they retreat and run back and do some the most stupid things and then you can take them out really easily. And I do notice the difference because people then gets a little bit more scared. Well, what's going on? That thing is so loud. That must be really painful or something like that. Meanwhile, if you're thinking about it, FPS is just the same as everybody else, more or less. So it doesn't make sense. But it's unconsciously, it's like, oh, that's scary. But of course it got some downsides as well, because everybody knows like, oh, there's that guy shooting. Because it's a distinctive sound that it makes. So it's fun, but at the same time doesn't have any use. There's also with this is like maybe 2 inches. You could better use a 2-inch barrel instead of you waste that 2 inches. A barrel that is 2 inches longer than using a muzzle brake on it, that is just wasted barrel length when you're playing. In my opinion, at least. It maybe looks cool, but yeah. Yeah, and without a muzzle brake on it, this should be a 14-inch barrel. So you can see how long it is on this shroud and how it would look. Also, you can clamp this part down so you cannot slide it that easily, but now for the sake of this movie it's easier to have it loose. This is how a 16-inch barrel would look like. For paintball terms, that is kind of a long barrel. 14 is mostly the like the standard for normal paintballs. And yeah. There you go, like maybe first strike, you maybe talk different size barrels. Probably the longest is 20 inch. But yeah, this is how that would look. This one is also from MCS, so you can use some barrel attachments. This suppressor is not a suppressor. It's you can hide your barrel inside of it. That is basically what it does. And in this case, if I would use this 16-inch barrel and this suppressor, it would hit the shroud. So what they have made is like a spacer. And this is like 1 inch. You will attach this on the barrel basically. And then attach the silencer on that part. So you can space it. It got also like a different size, probably 1 inch. So you can space it out correctly. What you also could do is remove the back part. And just attach it like this. Okay, because you don't really see it anyways. So with some shrouds you don't maybe like the look of the barrel sticking out really long past the barrel, past the shroud. So that's kind of why you could use, a reason why you could use the suppressor to kind of hide the fact that you use a long barrel on a shorter shroud. But yeah, that's how it would look. If you would like to use the stock TPX barrel, that would be too short with this shroud. Then it would sit something like this, so you could see it's too short. So that's why you could use a small shroud like this. There is an addition with just a rail at the bottom, or a grip like this one, or nothing. So you can just use your hand like that. Around this space. This one would use with work. This one would work with the TPX barrel to stick out a bit, but it's not too bad. If you really have something against barrels that's sticking out, then I got something for you. That's just crazy. this is also from MCS, back in the day it was called Rep 4. It's the SMG's barrel, I believe it is called. This one you need to turn in with your fingers. In the beginning you can use it a little bit like this, but then later you need to use your finger inside. It's not smart, and I don't talk it about some safety perspective, but if you use your finger, you use grease inside of the barrel and it could affect accuracy. So it's better to use the outside than use your finger and turn it that way. But yeah, it will be sitting flush with the shroud. So if you really want to go compact and sacrifice any sense of, you could say FPS and accuracy, then sure, go ahead. Just remove the buttstock and it's really compact. So yeah, it can be done, but it's really insane in my opinion. This will be 3.5 inch, so it's really really short. This one, the TPX barrel, is let's say 6 inch. It's a little bit longer than 6 inch, but then you get the point. This is the 13-inch barrel. I do have to say, 13-inch is a really odd size in paintball. You don't see that often. It's usually 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. 13 is really strange. This one came with a shroud. I don't really think it's hard to find a 13-inch, but since it's kind of a mix of both, let's use it with short shroud. So yeah, as you can see, this barrel sticks out really long. Looks kind of ridiculous in my opinion. So that would be in case that you could say like, yeah, let's use the fake suppressor. So it kind of hides the fact that the barrel is that long. So as you could see, if it would be in 12 inch, then yeah, I got this space removed. It would be even better, I think. It's a nicer look, but you get the point. So like 14 inch would be longer, would be looking kind of silly again. But like if it is a little bit shorter, it would look kind of nice, I guess. But then you could still have like a long barrel without having to print a really big shroud. And also if you are like, the benefit of it is like, if you are playing a few rounds and you want to have more range or more accuracy in that regard, that you have an effective range in paintball, you could say, like, okay, I use the long barrel like this, and then later you maybe say, like, oh, I want to do more the CQB stuff. Well, and then you remove just the barrel and use a shorter one, of course. If that is kind of your way of doing things in CQB. And that can be all done really relatively fast. Of course, keep in mind that you need to adjust the FPS. When you change your barrel, it will affect how fast your paintballs will go. Or first strikes in that case. But so yeah, keep that in mind. But in a sense, it's really fast to change it out. Then again, you just have to remove two screws. You can just change the shroud. It's not that hard to do. But yeah, that's really it. To just as the first glance, if you wonder about the color of this, this is the PET G, that's the plastic type, that's translucent in its nature, and this is like a transparent black, they call it. Sometimes it's also referred as smoke, but yeah, it's basically a transparent black, and when you print it, it will look yeah, like you could see really metallic metal looking, like a bare metal gun in this case. And I kind of like the look of it, kind of special. But yeah, they also have like, with PET G you can also use like a transparent green. And then you would get like a metallic green. Also kind of with the blue, but I must say with the blue, it is not that metallic looking as what you would like. Same with transparent yellow. Don't get fooled, it doesn't look like gold when you print it. It will look just like a metallic yellow. So for that color you do using different plastic. And if you go for a transparent PET G, you will get this color. It's really just white. It's like that, that awful white transparent plastic you sometimes see with some paintball pots that really stick out on the field. So I would not recommend it. It's not. It looks really nice and shiny and transparent when you don't print it, but once you start printing it, it will get really white. White translucent, so it's looked that great in my opinion, depending on what you go for, of course. But this is an open source project. You can modify every part of it as in the form of step files, and you can also just print it, of course. And I'm really curious to see how it will be received in the paintball community. I think it's a nice lightweight platform, and I'm really curious to see if this kind of is taken up also by, like, let's say the First Strike community. Oh, this is just a support piece that falls, not that you think it breaks. It looks kind of silly. But I'm really curious to see with the bigger shrouds and then the bigger barrels, if there maybe is taken up as like a semi-automatic carbine or something like that, with first strike swimmer or accuracy. At least in my opinion, I don't like the look of the TCR. I think it's silly. It looks like a pistol with a buttstock on it and things like that. I don't feel nothing for it. I don't like it. I care about the internals. I like the internals a lot. They are better than the TPX. They are definitely an improvement. But the look of it, I don't care for it. Then and the TPX, I like the TPX because it's like it's used regular paintballs and it is a pistol. It's a big pistol. It's more like a handgun, hand cannon than something else. So it's not really, in my opinion, secondary, but it's nice that it uses regular paintballs. But of course, if you want to get more range out of it, what I did in the past would use a barrel setup like this, so you could hide the fact that you use a longer barrel. But if you want to use longer barrels, it kind of is limited because it's in shape of a pistol. And in this case, it's kind of nice that you can use longer barrels and use optics on it. And yeah, sure, there were mods for the TPX that you could do that, but in this case, you can really make it any type of rifle in certain terms, of course, that you like. And have fun with it. And I hope that you guys do have fun with it, because I'm really excited to play with this. And a lot of sleepless nights, because I was working really hard on it and I was really excited, because then I was laying in bed and I was like thinking like, oh yeah, I should do this is next day, and I want to release this as fast as possible, because I want to see it be being finished. But yeah, it's almost there, and maybe when you watch this, it's already released. And yeah, so yeah, have fun with this project. Yeah. And also, because I know I will get this question, will there be a different edition for, like, let's say the TMC magazines, T15, blah 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 blah. I know all the type of magazine questions you will get. For now, it will be a no. But if there is really support for it, in the sense that it makes sense for me to spend more money on this project and to design further on it, that's sure, because to be honest, 12 rounds is kind of, yeah, it's not much if you can compare it with 20 rounds. So sure, it can be improved if you use like the bigger AR style magazines designs. But yeah, for now, because if you start to see the package, you will get it. It was a lot of work. You can choose like six different uppers. Probably about, let's say, 50 shrouds, and you got like seven stock options, so you can already customize it like your heart's content. And of course, you can go wild with the colors of it. So yeah, there you go, already got a lot of options. And yeah, so I hope that is appreciated, and that you guys have fun with it. And yeah, see you. Speak you guys next time.